Hi, I am Alexandra Barker. On average, the population of the country increased between July 1st, 2020 and July 1st, 2021, according to the Population Estimates Program. Population estimates are a great way to measure trends and changes in population for your area. The Census Bureau releases population estimates every year for the country, states, metropolitan and micropolitan areas, counties, cities and towns, as well as Puerto Rico and its municipios. It also produces housing unit estimates for the nation, states and counties. In this data gem, I'll show you where you can go to access population estimates for cities and towns. Let's go. First, it is important for you to know that these data are not available on data.census.gov. To access population estimates for any area below the national level, you need to visit the Population and Housing Unit Estimates page on census.gov. Or just click on the link right on the right top corner of this video. On this page, you have several resources available for you to learn about the Population Estimates Program and the data products. But let's find out how to get to the tables available for cities and towns for the Vintage 2021 Estimates Series. Here, click on Vintage 2021 Tables. Next, click on City and Town Population Totals 2020-2021. Right at the top, you have an opportunity to review the methodology used by the Census Bureau to calculate these estimates. Right below, you'll be able to access tables and datasets. In this first set of tables, you will see data for cities and towns with population of 50,000 or more for the years 2020 and 2021, ranked in three different ways: by population size, by cumulative estimates ranked by percent change, and by annual estimates ranked by percent change. Let's take a look at the table Annual Estimates of Resident Population Change for Incorporated Places ranked by the percent change. Click on the table name to download the Excel file. Now, let's open the file to look at the data. On this table, the first column shows the cities and towns for the entire nation ranked by the value on the last column, percent change. The columns for July 1st, 2020 and July 1st, 2021 show the population estimates for those years for each city and town. The next column, number, shows the difference in population between the 2 years. The percent column shows the percentage increase or decrease in population for these areas. For instance, here you see that Georgetown, Texas had the highest increase in population between 2020 and 2021 among all cities and towns with a 10.5% increase. Now, let's learn how to access tables for all cities and towns by state. For this example, I will select Florida, but please keep in mind that if you are looking for data for cities and towns in the Northeast states, it is recommended that you select your state from the Minor Civil Division list right here below the Incorporated Places list. The legal boundaries of towns in the Northeast are fully represented as a minor civil division. While if you use the place geography, you may be looking at data for a part of a town without even knowing that it does not reflect the official town lines. So let's click on Florida to download the table for all cities and towns in the state. Cities and towns will be listed in alphabetical order. The following columns show the population estimates for July 1st, 2020 and July 1st, 2021. You can use Excel features such as sort and filter to work with this data, as well as calculate your own percentage change for cities and towns in your area. Let me show you how to do this. Click on the empty cell next to the estimates. On the formula bar, type the equal symbol. Then click on the first estimate for year 2021. Now type the minus symbol. Now click on the estimate for year 2020 and press enter. You created a formula that shows the estimated number in population increase or decrease. Now, click on the cell and drag the green line down to apply the formula to the other cities and towns. To calculate the percent change, click on the empty cell next to the first number you just calculated. Type the symbol equal, then open parentheses. Click on the number, add the divided or forward slash symbol, click on the year 2020 estimate, close parentheses. For multiplying, add the asterisk symbol and the number 100 and press enter. Now you can drag down your new formula to apply it to other cities and towns. This is now the percent change in population for all cities and towns in this list. Let's go back to the website. The last thing I want to show you is that we also make this data available for you in CSV or dataset format. You want to use these files if you are planning on importing the data for analysis with a statistical analysis software. Population estimates are updated every year. This is why these estimates are so helpful when analyzing population trends. If you'd like to learn more about how these estimates are calculated, watch our data jam on this topic. And for more videos like this, visit census.gov/academy and don't forget to subscribe. Thank you!